dream is like a river, ever changing as it flows. And a dreamer's just a vessel that must follow where it goes. Trying to learn from what's behind you and never knowing what's in store makes each day a constant battle just to stay between the shores. And I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Like a bird upon the wind, these waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try. So I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Too many times we stand beside and let the water slip away, till what we put off till tomorrow has now become today. So don't you sit up on the shoreline and say you're satisfied. Choose to chance the rapids and dare to dance the tide. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Like a bird upon the wind, these waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try. So I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. And there's bound to be rougher waters, but I know I'll take some falls. But with the good Lord as my captain, I can make it through them all. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Like a bird upon the wind, these waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try. So I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Till the river runs dry.
Sincere condolences to all of you at this very difficult time. So I say welcome. In the name of Jesus, the Savior of the world, we are gathered to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, to remember before God Cameron, to give thanks for his life, to commend him to our merciful Redeemer, and to comfort one another in our grief. When we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today Cameron Tyler Jantz. We thank you for giving him to us to know and to love. as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. It's time for the sharing of memories or the eulogy. The family has prepared this, and so I will read it. Cameron Tyler Jantz was born at the Misericordia Hospital on July 31st, 1988. The whole family had been eagerly awaiting his arrival and were very excited when he finally entered the world. From the time he was young, Cam had a smile that would light up the room, and you couldn't help but smile back. When he was a kid, he had a goofy side that always kept everyone entertained, and that really didn't go away as he got older. Some memories from when he was little include playing pool with Grandpa, with his tiny pool cue, teaching cousin Deanna, who was 7 years older than him, to play duck hunt, saying, "My too," when he wanted to tag along. And Uncle Mike, pushing him for hours in the stroller at Silver Lake. We can't forget the mini golf or hours spent in the water there either. As a kid, Cam was lucky to have three older cousins that he got to spend lots of time with. Sitting on Jen's lap, playtime with Deanna, and of course the many, many weekends Katie babysat him and Ange. It's time none of them will ever forget. A few other memorable moments from when he was young include the trampoline long jump challenge that he and Ange had, where he launched himself onto the far side, caught his ankles on the frame, and went over the edge. He won that one. We can't forget when he tried to drive the quad up the swing set, or the time he educated his grade 2 class on how frogs mate. Cam loved sports. From the time he was young, he was quick to learn to ride a bike and didn't stop from there. He played t-ball, fastball, slow pitch, soccer, and football. He made it to high school provincials in track with the 100 meter and triple jump. But let's not forget the wipeout as he crossed the finish line on the track at the Butterdome during the Journal Games. The crowd groaned. He also took up the family sports of golfing and curling. Cam, Ange, Donna, and Marvin curled together as a family for years. The rest of the family often came out to watch them. Cam was also proud to have curled on the men's championship team with his dad. He was also pretty excited when he and his mom were on the winning team at the Jeff Kenney Memorial Golf Tournament. Cam eagerly followed in his family footsteps with his work life too. He went from watching his parents load pigs as a little boy to farming like his dad, Marvin, and Grandpa Edwin. He was passionate about the business and was planning to take on more responsibilities in the hopes of taking over once his dad retired. Cam was an avid outdoorsman. He loved hunting and fishing and did both every chance he got. There were many camping trips with the family to Valmont, quadding with his parents up the mountain, and perfecting his fly fishing skills. He took many fishing trips with friends over the years. As he got older, he began cooking and was more than happy to prepare his hunts to share with family and friends. When he was younger, he would go next door to Nanny and Grandpa's to eat sauerkraut and sausage and pie. As he got older, he started returning the favor, making sauerkraut with his mom and bringing Nanny and Grandpa ribs and other meals he was proud to have prepared. And rightfully so, he was a good cook. Travel had been a big part of Cam's life. Family vacations to the mountains, Kananaskis, Drumheller, Disneyland, SeaWorld, Yuma to visit Grandma Reed and Cliff, Europe, Mexico, Vancouver and Seattle, just to name a few. We all looked forward to the stories he'd tell when they returned. He often met the most interesting people. Cam was also musically gifted. Could play the piano, guitar, and drums. There were many hours spent jamming with Dylan and friends in the house or garage. The entire family had the pleasure of listening to his wonderful talent on many occasions. As Cam got older, he gathered more and more friends. One of his favorite things to do was hang out around the fire with them. They would joke and laugh and make memories to last a lifetime. Cam was a bright light in this world and affected people more positively than he could ever have known. If you ask those that knew him best, they would describe him as helpful, caring, loyal, and kind. He was one of the best people you had the pleasure being around. We're all better off for knowing him. He was a great brother, thoughtful son, helpful grandson, caring nephew, awesome cousin, and wonderful friend. Everyone will miss his smile, cheerful presence, and most of all, his hugs. You will be greatly missed, Cam. Until we meet again. And a reading from the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And a reading from the Gospel of John. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. These days, since the news of Cam's death, I expect have been some of the most difficult days of your lives. And today we have gathered for you to say your final farewell to his earthly life, another difficult day. Many years ago, Cam was baptized. He became part of God's family and had the benefits of baptism, forgiveness, life, and the promise of eternal life. It was and is a great gift from God. And now it is fulfilled. When death confronts us, our lives are disrupted and we are filled with sorrow and grief. The tears may flow, as you well know, and there may be confusion, regret, and maybe even anger. All of these are natural parts of the grieving process. And in the midst of it all, we gather together here and our community together. A community that surrounds you today, yes, those who are here in person, but also those who have reached out to you and those who will watch this recording. All of these people are a sign of hope, love, and care in the midst of this troubling time. Death does not make sense. It leaves us with empty holes in our hearts. We carry with us today, and likely for days to come, these mixed emotions of the empty places, along with the fond memories of Cam. In the midst of mourning, we are here also to celebrate and give thanks for Cam's life. Through the telling of memories, you celebrate his life. And I know you've been doing lots of this and will do more in the hours and days and years to come. This way you keep his memory alive and you acknowledge the contributions he made to those around him. We heard of many in the eulogy. And as you mentioned the other day, he has friends from coast to coast to coast because of who he was and how he interacted with all whom he met. Our reading from the Gospel of John for today is about Jesus trying to prepare his disciples for what was to come in the difficult days ahead, his suffering and death. These were troubling times for those disciples in the face of what was to come. And we hear these words, "Don't let your hearts be troubled. I am going to prepare a place for you." Jesus says these words because there were going to be times when it looked like death had won the day. In that dark time of our Lord's suffering, we learn something about our God. We learn that God suffers with us because God shared in the pain of the cross, and so too God shares in our pain and in our troubling times. This is the way God showed his great love for us. The terribleness did not end on the cross. God had and continues to have power over death and over life. There was resurrection, and that made all the difference. What was done for us through Jesus makes it possible for there to be a place for us with God. Jesus did this for those disciples. He has done this for Cam and for us too. You celebrated this at his baptism on the 11th of December in 1988, and again at his confirmation on the 27th of October in 2002. Jesus' resurrection tells us that nothing can separate us from God and God's love for us. There will be times when we cry out in confusion like Thomas, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" There will be times when we cry out when things don't feel all right because of the grief we experience. It is then when we rely on those around us to remind us not to let our hearts be troubled or afraid. Jesus has prepared a place for Cam and for us. When it is hard to continue on the journey of life, those around us can remind us that God is present with us. and continues to love us. And by what I heard you talk about when we met, it sounds like you have lots of people around you, and that is a huge blessing. We also heard the 23rd Psalm. So reassuring are these words for many times in our lives. Know that the Lord is your shepherd, who leads you beside cool waters and restores your soul. For sure, this will take time. Be patient with yourselves and with each other. Allow the love of God, expressed through the many people who love and care for you, to surround you and hold you close. Amen. It's time for the prayers. Each portion ends with the words, God of mercy. You are invited to respond with, hear our prayer. Let us pray. Almighty God, give courage and faith to all who mourn, and a sure and certain hope in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may have strength for the days ahead. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Grant to us, who are still in our pilgrimage, and who walk as yet by faith, that where this world groans in grief and pain, your Holy Spirit may lead us to bear witness to your light and life. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Help us, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. God of mercy, God of all grace, we give you thanks because by his death our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. If you know the words of the Apostles' Creed, I invite you to say them with me. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Now we come to the part where we commend camp to God. If you're able, I'd invite you to stand if you're not standing already. Let us commend Cameron Tyler Jantz to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Cam. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. We pray, Holy God, holy and powerful, by the death and burial of Jesus, your anointed, you have destroyed the power of death and made holy the resting places of all your people. Keep Cam, whose body we now lay to rest, in the company of all your saints, and at the last, O God, raise him up to share with all the faithful the endless joy and peace won through the glorious resurrection of Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Have you opened it, and if you would come and place in the area. Sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our brother Cameron Tyler Jantz, and we commit his body to its resting place, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord's face shine on him with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon him with favor and give him peace. Amen. Rest eternal grant him, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon him. And we pray, O Lord, support us all the day long of this troubled life until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes. And the busy world is hushed. The fever of life is over and our work is done. Then in your mercy, grant us a safe lodging and a holy rest and peace at the last. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And may Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless you all, now and forever. Amen. I invite you to take your time, and then when you're ready, to go in peace. We're going to play. This was one of Cam's favorite songs. You can sit.
Dream is like a river, ever changing as it flows, and the dreamer's just a vessel that must follow where it goes, trying to learn from what's behind you, and never knowing what's in store, makes each day a constant. Silver runs dry, makes each day a constant battle, just to stay between the shores. And I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Like a bird upon the wind, these waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination If I never try, so while you sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Too many times we stand aside and let the water slip away to what we put off till tomorrow has now become today. So don't you sit upon the shore and say you're satisfied. Choose to chance the rapids and dare to dance the tide. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Like a bird upon the wind, these waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try. So I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. There's bound to be rough waters, and I know I'll take some falls. But with a good Lord as my captain, I can make it through them all. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Like a bird upon the wind, these waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try, so I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Till the river runs dry.